Recorded Books presents Barbed Wire Baseball by Marissa Moss. Narrated by Brian Nishii. To Howard Reeves, Editor Extraordinaire. Marissa Moss. To my parents and my sister June, and my American family, Katie Yamasaki, without whom it would have been impossible to complete this project. Yuko Shimizu. Zeni watched the wooden bat thwack the baseball, hurling it high and straight. He was 8 years old, and it was the first time he'd seen a baseball game, but he was hooked. "Father, I want to play," he told his dad.
"You're too small," his father said.
"Too frail," added his mother. But Zeni didn't listen. He had to play. The other kids laughed at him.
"Zeni, you're a mouse," one boy hooted.
"A teeny tiny one," another kid called.
None of it mattered. When Zeni had a ball or bat in his hand, he felt like a giant, and soon he played like one. Many springs had passed since that first game, years of playing in the chill of winter and the sweat of summer. Zeni got taller and stronger and better at baseball.
"Why are you wasting time with a silly game?" his mother asked.
"You should study and become a doctor," his father said, "or a lawyer."
But Zeni knew exactly what he wanted to do, and when he grew up, he coached, managed, and played baseball in the Fresno Nisei League and the Fresno Twilight League. He was barely 5 feet tall and weighed only 100 pounds, but he was a star player, casting a big shadow in baseball. Zeni was chosen to play with star members of the New York Yankees. He led his teams in exhibition games in Japan. He even arranged for Babe Ruth to play there. But that world collapsed for him when the Japanese attacked Pearl Harbor in 1941. For the first time since he had picked up a bat, Zeni felt as if he didn't measure up. The United States was at war with Japan, and 120,000 Americans of Japanese descent who lived on the West Coast were forced into 10 internment camps, most in the desert. The government considered these Japanese Americans to be possible spies and, without evidence or trials, locked them up, men, women, and children. American citizens, all were treated like prisoners of war, housed in barracks and penned in with barbed wire. Zeni, his wife, and their two teenage sons were sent to a camp in Gila River, Arizona. Outside, the camp was bleak and gray and dusty. Inside, the barracks were stark, with crowded rows of cots and not much else. Families bustled around, trying to make a home out of nothing, hanging up curtains, arranging tea sets on footlockers, piling dolls and stuffed animals on cots. Zeni stood staring at the dry earth, which was broken up every now and then by a few scrubby bits of green. In all the brown and gray, with a dull, coppery sky overhead, he felt as if he were shrinking into a tiny, hard ball. There was only one thing that could make the desert camp a home: baseball. Zeni unpacked his favorite photo, the one that showed him in uniform, lined up with baseball legends Babe Ruth and Lou Gehrig, towering like redwood trees beside him. He had played with the Yankee stars in an exhibition game back home in Fresno, and he hadn't felt small at all. He pinned the picture up over his bed. He was going to play baseball again, here, in the desolate middle of nowhere. First, he would need a playing field. There was plenty of empty space, but it was dotted with sagebrush and clotted with rocks. It didn't look like much of a field. Zeni started by chopping down the plants and digging up the rocks, spending long hours in the blazing sun.
"What are you doing, Dad?"
his son Howard asked.
"Can't play baseball without a field," Zeni grunted.
"We're going to play baseball?"
Howard grinned and started picking up rocks too. Soon, Howard's brother, Harvey, joined them. Then other boys and men drifted to where Zeni and his sons were bent over in the glaring heat. By the end of the day, dozens of people were working on the field, not planting a crop, but unplanting, making the ground a smooth surface. Once the brush and the biggest rocks had been cleared, Howard and Harvey were ready to set up the bases.
"Looks good," Howard said. "We're almost set."
Zeni shook his head.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.